think Binder Lake qualifies for disaster relief today. Oh, look at that carp! If it bites me, I hope somebody finds this camera at the bottom of the lake.
Howdy, folks. Yesterday and overnight, we probably had 4+ inches of rain. So the lake is up. So right now we've got about maybe 3 or 4 hours to see if something's happening. So come on, let's go.
Before you even ask, let me say that I would never have launched a float tube in this mess, because I'd be sitting here in a canvas donut that is going shh and sinking. But this Pitt Boss is virtually indestructible. It's just astonishing. Putting your flippers on in this kick float is just phenomenally easy and convenient. All I'm gonna do is push off and away we go. See ya, flotsam. See ya, jetsam. And among other things, I'm interested to see what the water temperature is after that amount of rain came through. So we'll get this thing fired up and give you a water temperature report. Water clarity report is stained with sticks. The rowing speed is actually pretty good. It's not quite as fast as a kayak, of course, but it is a lot faster than just a float tube with kick fins. I think Binder Lake qualifies for disaster relief today, but we'll find out. This is the only tackle that I brought with me, just this one box. The one I'm going to start out with is a Stinky. I was probably looking at Layla when I was making these things. I'm just kidding, she doesn't stink that much. No, you may not believe this. This is the first cast. Oh, look at that carp! Oh, look at that carp! Look at that, jiminy Christmas. Now, I know he wasn't trying to catch this bass. Are you gonna let me catch you up there in this big net? Nope. He said bye-bye. From the looks of this guy's tummy, he has been just chowing down on whatever's blowing in against that dam. Right now, I'm just seriously kind of amazed that anything's biting on anything. See you later. That's a pretty good start. These Stinkies are either a TRD or a 2.5-inch zinkers, and on some of them I have the weed guard like this, and on others I have an exposed hook. It's supposed to look like a craw, so I'm using craw flavor. I think my Stinkies are going to work pretty good. What is that? Is it organic, vegetable, mineral? Is it a tapeworm? Is it a radish? It's the weirdest looking thing I've ever seen. If it bites me, I hope somebody finds this camera at the bottom of the lake. What is that? I don't know. That is the most bizarre looking thing I've ever seen. Okay, you wildlife biologists, start biologing and tell me what this crazy thing is. I think I'm gonna take this home to Sparky and he might want to mount it. Okay, so here we are about to go over the dam with all this current. There is some substantial current out here. See ya. That little rascal's got everything a TRD's got, and maybe even a little bit more. Because when I get sprayed in the face, the camera's usually got sprayed in the face. Can't complain about the weight of these little guys. I got the biggest drops off with my blue towel that a friend of mine gave me. Somebody that likes getting all the nice Christmas presents that I send him. I think I actually provide more fishing tackle than he does, but this is nice. Thank you, Sparky. There's a bunch of them on this side. I think these are obviously males. they could be harbingers of the spawn. So why don't you continue to harbinge, okay, buddy? Let's see what we got. I'm gonna keep this entire rig. Next time Sparky goes crappie fishing, he can just tie it on. He can just splice the line in somewhere and just have a blast. Lily pad fish. Where are your mamas? Keep doing your thing. Interestingly, the water temperature over here is 65 degrees. If I were in a float tube, I see I'd be down on water level almost. But this puts me up there and I can see where the little pockets are in the lily pads. Yep. Someone asked on another video, do I like the kick float version better than the mini boat? No, not really. I mean, what I like is that if I'm going longer distances, that trolling motor equipped mini boat is the cat's meow. But if I'm just messing around, not going very far, I am right at home in a float tube type of a configuration. All right, Bobby, you know the deal. I'm only keeping track because this is one of those it shouldn't be happening days. Right around this area last month, I met a student from Helias High School. His name was Jackson, and he was right out in there in a kayak. So let's take a look at the cameo. And how you doing, Jackson?
Good. Nice to see you.
Goes to Helias High School here in Jefferson City. He's on their bass club. So what do you think about this Pitt Boss thing I'm sitting in?
I think that's just about the only thing you can get.
It's definitely an interesting craft, don't you think?
Yes, sir, for sure.
And you said you saw me as you were paddling across the lake and you thought, what is that guy doing out there in that cardboard box?
Yeah, really, I couldn't tell if it was a cardboard box or a non-motor kayak.
But now that you've seen it up close, you're impressed, aren't you?
Oh, definitely.
All right, so you have to say, good job, Mr. Garrett.
Good job, Mr. Garrett.
God bless, Jackson. Thank you, Jackson. It was nice to run into you, and hope to see you out here again sometime. Bye-bye. This is the day that should not be happening, and I'm glad I'm here for it. See ya. I don't think that's a she. I think that's just a he with a big belly full of chow. And I'm not sure when we can safely conclude that these stinkies are just fabulous, but I don't know. Why don't we start now? See ya. I hope you're paying attention about this stinky that I'm using today. We'll talk more about it at the end. Sun came out, and so we're gonna make one last transit to the parking lot and call this trip that should never have occurred concluded. It's been a lot of fun. Hey, before we go, let's talk about the little stinky here. This is the exact same lure that I tied on at the beginning of this trip. And this is what the lure looks like after 16 fish. But this one here is not even ripped at all. And it's simply because of that magnificent Elastec stuff that Z-Man makes its TRDs out of. This little stinky was a good choice today, and I think we both made a good choice to go along on this trip. So until we see you again, from here in Jefferson City to wherever you are, have a great day and God bless.